يعطيكم العافية. أنا الطالب محمد سامي الحافي. التوبكس Introduction of Postmodern Cities. بداية رح أبلش في Table of Content. حكي عن Abstract Introduction on the Postmodern Cities Condition, Postmodern Geographies, Fragmentation of Urban Space, وهعطي شوية Example of Postmodern Cities. بالنسبة للأبستراكت, a new type of cities has undoubtedly been taking shape in the latest decades to which commodity and lack of better expressions is giving the name of postmodern city. It's a compact city with a sealed social zoning and precise limits, whose center shows a related social homogeneity, stored in a group of distinct fragments where the effects of cogent continuity and urban redundancy give way to more complex and discontinuous territorial formations, which are socially and spatially enclaved. This process is partially due to the fact that since the end of 1960, housing in cities of advanced capitalism has been facing significant change through the emergence of a new housing products and new forms of accommodation by gentrification. As a response to growing social fragmentation and complexity, these changes have influenced the urban spatial organization toward an increasing micro-scale segregations. Postmodern culture was born as a way to combat the modern movement, overtaking the severity of the international style regarding its architecture. Hence, postmodern architecture proposed not to be bound to any rule or style aspects. Because of that, urban transformations have been brought to postmodern city. Some of these are chaotic and not related to the urban experience of the individual. Thus, space and time are modified into this new city. Postmodernism intends from the outset to create a new expression not only in artistics but also in cultural terms, which will bring a new and contradictory aesthetic experience that seek to represent contemporary society. As a result, the new architecture is now reflected, generating a new society freed from aesthetic, philosophical, and social budget of the mid-20th century. However, the term postmodernism has raised many debates in order to find a clear meaning covering all variation of this cultural wave. Postmodernity is not an artistic movement in this strict sense, but rather an expression of the crisis of modernity, understood as a critique of modernity itself. Nevertheless, at some point, it's difficult to overcome this given solution. This plurality makes community views of society as a whole considering. The postmodern city relate itself to urban imaginary, which is composed of a conglomeration of ideas and images. These are built through the visual memory and individual imaginary creation that have to do with the use of the visual intelligence form.
هنتقل بعد على النقطة الأولى اللي هي the postmodern city condition. The indeterminacies surrounding the material and mental constructs of urban geography were complicated by a renaissance in social theory during the last quarter of the 19th century. The rise of post-structuralism, post-modernism, feminism, post-colonialism altered the epistemological and ontological basis of knowing the urban space. Broadly speaking, such approaches shifted attention to cultural realism and questioned the cognitive foundations of truth claims from all persuasions. The enduring importance of post-modernism, ontological and epistemological challenge has been widely accepted. The rationalists of the scientific revolution and the Enlightenment have been challenged, replacing a belief in truth. Foundationalism and laws with belief based in relativism, pragmatism, and indeterminacy. The central tenets of modernism have been overridden by a cacophony of different voices, each claiming to offer something that helps us understand the world about us. Just as the core beliefs of modernist thought have been displaced by postmodernism, multiple ways of knowing. So has the nation of a universal urban process been dissolved by the multiplying logics that are transforming city making?
At the core of this transformation is the altered relationship between city and hinterland. In the short, the process of becoming urban involves altered structure and functional relationships at the inter and intra-urban scale that are radically different from those in the modern city. The multi-centered or polycentric city is now constitutive of the urban and the urban question, not the classic monocentric urban center. According to Phillips in 2005, in the 1980s, human geography has been influenced by a wider variety of intellectual influences, including those associated with some notion of postmodernism. The study of gentrification has not been immune from these changes, and indeed, in many respects, has been amongst the leading sites of contestation over the significance of ideas of postmodernism. Many of the areas described as having been gentrified are said to incorporate the elements of postmodern architecture, and thereby becoming a postmodern landscape. Postmodernism can be perceived as referring to an architectural style which seeks to be different from the modernist convention of high rectangular, large-scale regularly laid out and uniform constructed buildings. By contrast, postmodern architects sought to introduce variation in building surface, shape and size, with much of this variation being derived from sticking elements of different style to create a pastiche. A second element of postmodernism in human geography has been an emerging distrust of the grand theory. Clear examples of grand theories are the theories of logical positive spatial science, but it can also be seen to be applied to another seemingly quite different approaches. Hence, Marxism, for example, can be seen to be grand theory through its use of concepts like modes of production and class struggle. By contrast, postmodernists suggest that there are multiple causes of the gentrification phenomena and their importance will vary considerably from one situation to another. It can be said favor Hampel and eclectic theory formation of local knowledges. وصولا بالنقطة الثالثة اللي حشرح فيها عن البوست مودرن جيوغرافيز by describing two main elements are connected with the post modernism city. The first element is the gentrification and the second element is the fragmentation of urban spaces. So moving from the big cities to the old and poor cities is more to be made these days by the young people. Therefore, old cities will be thrilled because these young people who just moved to poor places have increased the living situation by bringing more source supplies and money to them. Simply, these poor cities will get substantial upgrade due to concessions that will come with the rich people movement. Unfortunately, the former resident will no longer be able to afford the life there because it will extremely rise up. Gentrification is a phenomenon connected with the postmodernism cities. It will deprive the former resident of their assets and force them to move out. Also, it will destroy the original culture of the city and build new hoods and modern places are called gentrification. It's recomposing the community and isolate the rotten part as they consider it. Each individual may pretend that he owns a territory because he only lives there. However, this can create a big hurdle between the communities because it generates a confusion over the city's primary social divide lines. Unfortunately, space appropriation is a characteristic of the gentrification. Each individual may pretend that he owns a territory because he only lives there. However, this can create a big hurdle between the community because it generates a confusion over the city's primary social divide lines. Unfortunately, space appropriation is a characteristic of the gentrification. Intrusion can be seen inappropriate by the former resident, which clearly defines the phrase space appropriation. When new buildings start to appear in the old cities and new people start to move in, you will obviously see that gentrification provides an ideal example about urban space organization. Thus, it enhances the nature of the post-modern city. As a result, real estate projects create a significant difference in the surrounding areas. The relationship between the enclaves and the surrounding area is very essential in this case. Basically, disconnecting the community from the outside territories creates what is called the fragmentation of space. Even though the new people who moved to the poor cities have implemented a new real estate project, they are still unable to create successful relationships or even communicate properly with the surrounding areas due to the big difference in the activities they do and the different concerns as well. Therefore, you will notice that the city is improving quickly. Also, it's kind of a new system that forced those people to cut off their past relation and focus on how to make a progress. For example, Toronto, Canada and New York City are two crowded cities and entirely developed. Now, if you go there, look at the people in the streets, you will immediately feel that they are robots. Even if you were hit by a car, they won't even stop to look at you. They will keep going like nothing happened. In the post-industrial cities, it's kind of different when it comes for the relationships. The relationships are less than the post-modern cities. Yet, each individual has his own way to create a relationship and friendships further than his hood. Apparently, is the revolution that happened in the transportation and communication has helped those people for a better relations. One of the biggest problems that forced the postmodern cities was to keep the identity of the city solid and stable. Of course, after destroying the community, it's very likely that you may face these kind of problems. The contemporary experience is fragmented, disordered, and polyvalent. Also, the geographers have attacked one-dimensional ontology imposed by structuralism that supported gentrification. In this presentation, I will discuss two examples of postmodern cities and their own contradictions. So starting with East London as the first example, it provides an ideal example of a postmodern city in that the area seems disconnected and has a multiple use along with the varying representation and discourses of the area and those who live and work in the area by media forms. Although East London has become renowned as a typical modernist slum where concentrated numbers of working class life work, due to the gentrification of this area, a certain layering of this area is taking place and working class residents are being displaced to make way more for affluent inhabitants. The second example is Las Vegas. Las Vegas falls into this category because of the postmodern approach that it has taken in construction. There's not a lot of functionality design into the architecture. It's more based in the idea of drawing people individually with aesthetics, paradox, irony, pluralism, all taking a priority to functionality. And that's all for the presentation, and thank you.
If you have any further question, please don't hesitate to ask.